I'm Tony, and if you saw the clip from Wednesday, then you know that this is the second part of the unboxing. Enjoy!
Okay, and speaking of police vehicles, now we are going to move to another continent, so I'm going to present you a Japanese police vehicle from a manufacturer that now is called Toyota, if I'm not mistaken, but on that period of time it was called Toyopet. This is an Ebro model. Ebro does a fantastic job on their models. I really regret that I don't have as many models as I would like from Ebro, as I'm very, very happy with their quality standards. This one also has the quality control stamp on it, and the details for this this type of Japanese police car are quite nice. I'm very pleased with this one. Okay, let's see what's next. We'll move from an old police vehicle to a modern hypercar. A hypercar made by Sofiart. Sofiart is the little brother of the Frontyard manufacturer. The Frontyard, for those who does not know about it, is a very premium manufacturer with lots and lots of details. And to my joy, I can say the same about this Sofiart version. This is a Koenigsegg Regera. Great model in a fantastic light blue with black, with brown interior. Probably it wants to imitate some leather interior. Great details. You can see carbon rims on it, and it looks absolutely fantastic. All details on it are top notch. I have no complaints on it. We have also some leather part on the stand, black with red. Very, very cool looking model. Well, usually Sofiart as Frontyard, and Frontyard as well, are making very limited editions model. In this case, it is not mentioned on the box how limited it is, but I'm pretty sure that they didn't make more than 500 units. Let's go back to the Japanese and present a car that for me it looks like a muscle car, but of course it is a lot smaller, but I'm pretty sure that it had the same amount of fun when driving. So this is from the 72, the Nissan Skyline Hardtop 2000 GT Racing that was presented at the Tokyo Motor Show, and this is one of the first model cars that I presented on my second channel, Model Cars Gears and Awards with Tony. So if you are curious about it, I invite you to check it out. You might enjoy it. Regarding this model, tell me if this one doesn't look like a muscle car, because for me it really, really looks like a little muscle car, as it is smaller than the Mustang and of course the bigger brothers like Challenger and so on, or Gran Torino in Ford's case. Okay, let's see what we have next. Now it's time for an Europe GT3 car. This one is a very nice Porsche made by Onyx, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, Onyx for the Le Mans collection. This is a Porsche 911 GT3R in Romanian. 3, it's pronounced 3, so you'll hear me from time to time adding some Romanian words in my conversation. It has a very nice bird livery, awesome looking rims, quite some cool details when it comes to the headlights with the interior. You can see the roll bar. You'll also have one chair, only the driver's chair. It is a very nice model, and being an Onyx, it was quite cheap. Now, give me 1 second, please, to adjust the lighting on the camera. Now, let's go back to the Japanese models. Also an Ebro model, so you'll expect that the details are quite nice. This is a very little and cute Suzuki Fronte SS from the 68. Very cute little car. As you can see, it's very, very small. Very, very nice design on it. It has a wooden steering wheel. An absolutely cool little car. It's very similar with the Fiat 500. I have a Fiat 500 right here, so I will unbox this as well. And maybe when I will unbox it, we will compare these two cars, because as I said earlier, it is quite similar. Let's put this aside, have it on hand when I will unbox that one. Cool. Now let's go to a Czech car. Czech is the country where Skoda is made. For quite some time, Skoda made some very cool cars. I actually like the modern Skodas as well, but now they are focusing more on cheaper or more accessible cars for the people. But at that moment, their design were very similar with the ones from the luxury manufacturers. And this is the LMK, it's from Laurent and Clement, Skoda 110 Kombi. You have the possibility to make it, to adjust it, to put the roof on and leave the space disc free, or to put both roofs on and make it covered entirely. The details are quite nice. The manufacturer for this car is Abrex, also from Czech Republic. Very, very cool car. I need to make a separate clip for this vehicle because I'm a big fan of it.